Hey friends, welcome back to OG Universe. Thank you so much for stopping by today on the turntable. We're taking a look at the brand new McFarlane Toys DC Multiverse NFT digital wave of action figures. This wave consists of three figures. We're getting a Rebirth Batman, a classic Aquaman, and a Silver Age Green Lantern. I almost said Green Arrow, but he's coming in the next wave. We got a Silver Age Green Lantern. I'm very excited for that action figure. It's going to be coming up next in our reviews. But today we are taking a look at this version of Batman via the Rebirth stylization. A very cool costume, very modern, very techy, very different from our classic Nightfall Batman, which we've seen a few times here in our reviews. That's a good standalone kind of representation of classic version, new versions, different versions of Batman, tons of versions of Batman. But this figure does come with some very cool accessories. And one thing that I'm very happy McFarlane Toys is listening to, we're getting some additional head sculpts. Yes, we got an unmasked head sculpt here of Bruce Wayne, and it looks absolutely fantastic. It is so well done. You definitely see a classic Bruce Wayne with that square jawline, piercing eyes, real nice hairstyle. And what I really appreciate is this new casted plastic. Instead of getting a painted skin tone that sometimes comes out so pale, sometimes they cast in such a pale white, it looks just awful. But this one, skin tone is fantastic, realistic looking, just fantastic version of Bruce Wayne in an unmasked style. Looks great. Very appreciative of that. So you also get a few other accessories here. You get the gold grapnel launcher, you get a couple extra pairs of hands, and you also get a gold batarang. Now the gold batarang, yeah, we've seen this a few times already. This is the first time we've seen it casted in gold. But yeah, it's a very nice addition to the figure. We get a lot of accessories with this figure. In addition, let's take a look at the packaging. The packaging is a little bit different. So we got here, Batman, McFarlane Toys Digital, DC Rebirth. Inside, we got really nice card artwork of the representation on the back. We also got a NFT digital redemption code, and we got a new display stand there, McFarlane Toys Digital. And on the back, we got this smashing artwork of Batman via Jim Lee from Justice League. It's a variant cover. One thing I really like here, look at that. He does have a gold grapnel launcher. So there you go. True to what you see on the back is what you get inside. He even has those kneecaps there, sculpted to kind of look like kind of a bat emblem, so to speak. But yeah, this figure itself is very well done. The body buck, as I said, we've seen it a few times already, traditionally in a dark gray and a black, but we've got different head sculpts. So it's pretty cool to see. It did come in a 3-pack as well with Amazon exclusive. Oh, that 3-pack's a point of contention with me. You'll see, I never reviewed it because I actually returned it back to Amazon. It was, without a doubt, hands down, the worst QC plagued figure set I've ever purchased. The only good thing was the Batman. The Batman looked awesome. All the joints were fantastic. Unfortunately, my Batwoman, you don't see her in any of my videos. I did a short about her. The figure's joints were so loose, especially in the knees, that it could not stand. It topples over. Nothing you could do to really fix it unless gluing it. And I really don't want to glue my joints and work them through to try and stiffen it. If you wait too long, that glue stiffens and you're done. And then the clay face. The clay face was absolutely terrible. I was so looking forward to that action figure. Unfortunately, it was a hollow piece of garbage. Just so brittle. Oh my God. It was just not well done. I'm very, very sorry to hear that happened and that we got such a bad figure. Hopefully you guys who purchased it, maybe I got the one QC one that was terrible. Hopefully you guys got a better version. It is currently still on Amazon.ca here in Canada. It's $59. If it goes down a little bit lower in price, I might pick it up again just to get another Batman and hopefully get a better version of Batwoman, because that figure was really nice. But man, the QC was bad. Anyways, I digress. Let's talk about this figure. And this figure, no QC problems whatsoever. Standout figure, tight joints, great articulation, beautiful paint apps. The head sculpt here, let's take a look at that head sculpt. It just screams Batman. It is sculpted so damn well. It does have a resemblance to a David Finch piece of artwork. If you don't know who David Finch is, he was the artist that's done tons of work for Marvel DC. His period of time on Rebirth Batman, his first few issues were fantastic. He did a great storyline with Bane as well. definitely a great artist. I met him in person at Comic-Con here in Canada. Very cool, great guy, very nice, and great Canadian. And there you go. That's enough about David Finch. The figure itself does look very well done. You can get him some great poses, great articulation. We'll go into that in a few, but one thing about this body buck that just doesn't sit well with me is these skinny arms compared to these tree trunk legs. These legs are massive. Arms are so small and thin. That's the only thing I just, could have been done a little bit better. Just give him a little bit more bulk in the arms. I was thinking about doing some sort of swap out on the previous version, the first version, which is that dark gray, a little easier to match up. Maybe we'll do some toy surgery. I'm gonna show you the results of that. But this figure, besides the arms, it is really nicely well done. I appreciate all the attention, the detail. The paintwork is fantastic. There could have been a lot of slop in this gold and black trim on the belt. Nothing. Bat logo looks fantastic as well. The cape is sculpted so nicely. All the folds, wrinkles, looks absolutely great. And let's take a look at his articulation. Now, this figure does have something here that I'm gonna have to fix. Spacer joint, as you can see, there is a spacer joint in there, but it's so deep inside that arm socket, it doesn't really add any extra articulation, doesn't do anything for that spacer butterfly hinge. But that can be worked on. We'll pop these arms, we'll move that spacer out properly and see what happens. Now for articulation, yeah, he's got a really great range of motion for that head joint. He does have a longer peg. We're gonna swap the heads out in a second. We'll take a closer look at it. As you can tell, the spacer joint not really functioning too well there, but you do have full range of motion. You do have the cut at the bicep, double jointed ratcheted elbows, ball joints at the wrists. Now for his torso articulation, he can lean back quite a bit, go forward quite a bit. So you got a really nice range of motion. He does have the ball joint at the waist as well. Ball joints at the hips, double joint ratcheted elbows, and check out those knee pads. You got a little Batman head going on there. There you go. And you also got all the toe articulation you want. You got the side articulation rocker, everything going on. Your ball joints kind of covered up by these really nice stylized boots. And it's sculpted in there as well. So yeah, even on the bottom of the boots here, we got some bat tread, very cool. But yeah, I do like this figure. Small limitations on the arms, but not the end of the world. And as you can see there, it does have a longer extended neck peg. We've seen a lot of work on these neck pegs in my Definitive Superman video, where we made that really nice Superman from the Jim Lee Hush infected Superman body buck. But let's take a look at this figure with that Bruce Wayne head on. Goes on nice and easy. No difference in articulation. You still have a lot of movement. It looks really cool. You'd have this guy in your Batcave talking to the Bat family. Hopefully one day we're gonna get an Alfred. I would really like a classic comic book version of Alfred, or maybe some sort of diorama set that has the Bat computer and a little bit of the Batcave, or a real big Batcave would be really cool. I'd love to see that. Who knows, maybe one day we'll see that. That would be fantastic. But yeah, very cool figure. Let's do a bit of size comparisons. Let's pop this head off and let's put the traditional Batman head back on. And there you go, super easy. Here's that nice thud, thump, and you know that figure is secure. That head sculpt is secure. Yeah, let's just get this positioned a little nicely. There we go. So let's take a look at some other Batman in the blue and gray. We have the Hush Batman, which is probably my favorite Batman. These two are nicely stylized together. We do have a height discrepancy for sure. As you can tell, this Batman is sitting a little bit taller, and especially in the shoulders there, and of course much bulkier. You can see the arms, this guy's got huge arms, a little spindly, thinner arms, but both of these figures look great. I really do appreciate the way they can do different versions of Batman without having to feel like, man, I just got this figure a little while ago. But no, you're getting some really nice variations on the Batman. Then we also have this one here. Now this one is the Jim Gordon as Batman. And what we did with this one, we swapped out the head because I didn't really like the head on it too much. It just seemed too big for the body. And we took actually the original Rebirth head and swapped it onto this body buck. And I think this looks much better, much more proportionate to the body, because this is a thinner body buck. We've seen this used on the young adult bodies. We've seen it on Nightwing, Beast Boy, Superboy, impulse as well. So it's used to good extent for that. And I think these two kind of pair well because, you know, Batman is going to be a bit bigger than Jim Gordon for sure. But this one, it's got a nice, unique look to it. Something different. Very cool. I can appreciate it. And then we got one of my favorite versions of the Joker here. And this is that Infinite Frontier Joker. Kind of very heavily stylized Joker, but man, it's cool. I'm really looking forward to that Punchline and Joker 2-pack coming out shortly. Reese kind of working of this figure. We're going to see a head sculpt that has two eyes by the looks of things. As this one, as you can tell, he only has one eye and his other eyeball is right in his hand. I thought that was cool. The gun here comes from the McFarlane Toys munitions pack. And man, it's just great to have those packs. I think they're awesome. You can finally get some weapons for some of your DC characters. I know the embargo on any kind of weapons being, can guns being used in WB licensed products. It's kind of annoying, but you know, maybe that'll pass one day, but at least we have those munitions packs. I think they're on the third one already. The third one, it's a lot of kind of bright Fortnite colored guns that just don't do it for me, but some of them are pretty cool. I might get it if I can find it somewhere at a reasonable price and do some repainting on it. It's pretty easy to repaint those weapons. And then we got a couple more figures here I want to bring in. So this is another blue and gray Batman. I love how these two, they're Batman, but the contrasting styles. We got that classic look. It reminds me of a 70s Super Powers, Super Friends kind of Batman. I know it's from Nightfall, which is in the 90s, but this one just has that classic element. The capsule belt, that bat logo, the color of the gray and the blue just looks so good. The wrinkles in the fabric, it's a phenomenal figure. This one, contemporary, the Rebirth stylization, that really kind of layered body armor. Still, I really like that too, but it's just a great contrast to see these two characters together, kind of a classic and a new Rebirth version. So there you go, guys. This has been a very cool figure, a very interesting wave of figures. As I said, my Aquaman review, this figure came out super cheap. He was like about $23 Canadian, which is surprising because these figures I was expecting probably be like $32, $31 because of the NFT, but that NFT didn't cost anything extra. In fact, they were lower than the regular price of an action figure here. Usually they're around $26. So I don't know, it was a special deal or what was going on, but man, I'm happy to swoop up all these three figures from this wave at a really good price. So let me know what you guys think. NFTs, are those kind of interesting to you? Do you have any idea even what an NFT is? Let me know in the comments. I'm not the biggest fan. It just doesn't do it for me, but I'm glad we did get the extra accessories with this figure. I thought that extra head sculpt was fantastic. And hopefully my friend does more of these additional throw-ins. Would be great. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. Remember to like, comment, subscribe. I got a huge playlist of DC Multiverse reviews and some other stuff that you might find interesting as well. But thanks so much for watching, guys, and have an awesome day. We'll see you next time.